Turn Signal with Kim Troby.
Yesterday, I introduced you to a man named Phil Klein. Klein is the district attorney for Johnson County, Kansas. And as I told you yesterday, he is single-handedly taking on the abortion industry in his neck of the woods. Another case he's pursuing is against Planned Parenthood of Greater Kansas City. Today, we continue with part two of our interview. Let's start with Johnson County. Give me a little background on that particular case.
Well, while I was Attorney General, a judge who had been overseeing an investigation found probable cause to believe that there were evidence of crimes in medical records, abortion records maintained by Planned Parenthood and George Tiller. And so we subpoenaed those records with the judge's supervision. All the names of patients were redacted. As the investigation proceeded, as you know, I was defeated for Attorney General, much of it over this issue. And my opponent assumed the office of Attorney General, and I became Johnson County District Attorney and replaced him. Johnson County is where Planned Parenthood is located, so I was able to continue the investigation. As the investigation proceeded with other evidence, in Kansas, as in most states in the nation, you present that evidence to a judge when you're ready. If the judge finds probable cause to believe that crimes have been committed and probable cause to believe that the target or Planned Parenthood have committed those crimes, you file criminal charges. And last October, I filed a 107-count criminal complaint against Planned Parenthood of Western Missouri and Kansas. And that case is proceeding now through the process.
Now, they have fought you tooth and nail every step of the way. Tell me a little bit about where things stand currently.
Well, right now, there are several proceedings that are going on. Planned Parenthood has sued me personally. That case is before the Kansas Supreme Court. Planned Parenthood and the Attorney General have sued me. There are numerous ethics complaints that they have filed against me. Most of those have been knocked down. Some of them are still pending. The way that this process works, and when you deal with an industry, from my perspective, and my job is to enforce the law. I'm not prosecuting them because of what they do. I prosecute them because I believe they violated the law. But this is an industry that is engaged in destruction, and that's what they know. And so anybody they do battle with, that is their effort. It is to destroy them.
What happens next? Do you have some things going on with this particular case? Where do you go from here?
There are numerous things going on. We are before the Kansas Supreme Court for the fifth occasion on what is a simple investigation and criminal prosecution based on medical records, which is done every day in America. Every violent crime I prosecute, I just prosecuted a 34-year-old murder case and got a conviction. I have medical records. You use medical records for every Medicaid fraud case. And these are medical records with no identity, so they're not as sensitive as the normal medical records I use. But simply because it deals with abortion, all the rules go out of the window and it's Alice through the looking glass. And we're up to the Kansas Supreme Court on our fifth argument, dealing with patient privacy when there's no patient identities, and we've never revealed, never sought, nor will reveal or seek patient identities. All we're doing is trying to present evidence of criminal activity by business and industry that has violated the law, in our opinion. But in any event, those arguments go on June 12th. The criminal process is still going on. The strategy of those who oppose me is simply to try to outlast me. They haven't been able to kill me. They haven't been able to defeat us. They're just trying to outlast us, and we're in year six, and we're still standing.
There is a real sense of urgency to the case because Klein's tenure as DA is nearly over.